Hey everyone, hope you're all well. Today we got an awesome image detailing the exact date and time for the Xbox E3 showcase. Halo Infinite will be the star of the show, no doubt, with the image revealed by Xbox heavily focusing on different multiplayer Spartans with Reach-inspired armor. And boy, do these look awesome. We've known for a while now that Halo Infinite's customization would be heavily inspired by Halo Reach, which is great because I think it's safe to say that Reach had the best customization in the whole series. From this Xbox image, it's clear that the multiplayer will be the core focus for the Halo Infinite showcase, which really excites me. I predicted this in my previous vids, but we still will get a campaign slice, be it another gameplay or a gameplay trailer. We've heard next to nothing about Halo Infinite's multiplayer, so definitely expect a massive multiplayer reveal for Infinite, which should cover the majority of the presentation. Now let's take a look at the Spartans and their armor. Front and center, we have the beautiful Mark 7 with a Reach-style helmet attachment. Remember that Halo Infinite's customization will be even better than Halo Reach, so we will be able to customize the smallest of things on both the armor and helmets, which means attachments to armor and helmets will be done individually, as opposed to what Halo 5 did, which was not received very well. It will be interesting to see all the new helmet attachments that will be unlockable, because that's something I love messing around with on my multiplayer Spartan. We can also see Emil's EVA helmet, which looks amazing and highly detailed, as well as the Commando and Scout helmets, which again were from Halo Reach. I'm not sure why there's a huge emphasis on Reach helmets, but I can't complain because they all look fantastic. I have to highlight the Schmog or Ghillie chest piece on the Spartan rocking the Commando helmet, or it was more commonly known as June's cloth. The Ghillie chest piece was one of my favourite armour pieces that I basically wore all the time back in Halo Reach. Let me know if you're happy to see it return too. The Stalker rifle was showcased in all its glory for the very first time. We had only seen it in toys, but this is the weapon the Jackal snipers will be using throughout Halo Infinite. Many people think it will be a replacement for the carbine, and while that may be the case, I think it will be a replacement for the beam rifle. Plus, it fits the Banished theme a lot more. I've got to say, I really like the look of the Stalker rifle. It looks very powerful and fits the Banished aesthetic. Can't wait to see some gameplay of it. We get our first glance at the new and improved Sidekick, and holy shit, it looks way better. Here's a quick comparison of how the Sidekick looked last year during the July gameplay demo compared to now. It's really nuts how clunky the old version looked, as it even seemed weird when Chief was holding it. The newer version has been scaled down to look natural in a Spartan's hand, and it finally looks like a Halo pistol. The old version did not look like something out of the Halo game, which is why so many fans are upset with its introduction, and is the reason why 343 immediately addressed that, and they've done a great job changing it to something you'd more likely see in the Halo universe. Also, it appears that this Sidekick is rocking the Watchdog skin, which has a white, black, and red colour scheme, so just remember that this isn't the actual colour of the Sidekick, and will most likely see that at E3 during the multiplayer reveal. The Mark 7 Spartan is holding an assault rifle that has a red coating on it. This must be a new weapon skin, seen as it's mainly red and black. I do really like the look of it though. There are two pelicans in the back next to the EVA and Commando Spartans, and while it may not look like much, it could be a teaser for the Big Team Battle 2.0 mode, where it's been said by Clobberal, trusted Xbox insider, that Infinite will have pelican drops and massively enhanced vehicular combat, which is just super exciting. He's been pretty spot on with everything else regarding Halo Infinite so far, and because Halo Infinite's E3 showcase will be focused on the multiplayer, that's most likely why they are teasing the pelicans with the multiplayer Spartans. I have a strong feeling that the new massive mode getting introduced in Infinite will be the main feature of the Halo Infinite presentation at E3. Xbox only released this one image, but I've got to say that I'm so hyped for Halo Infinite right now. It's actually quite ridiculous. And I really hope 343 knock our socks off with Halo Infinite's huge multiplayer reveal. I just know it'll be awesome. Alrighty guys, that's going to wrap it up for today. Just a quick reminder that I'll be streaming my reaction to the Halo Infinite E3 showcase taking place June 13th. I'll set up a live stream soon so it's ready to go. All you need to do is click the bell to be notified when I go live. This is something you don't want to miss. Also, the Insert Infinite update for this month has been shifted forward until after E3, which makes sense, but just wanted to let you all know in case you're wondering why I'm not streaming any news as per usual. Just want to say thanks so much for the support leading to E3. I honestly have the best community here on YouTube, and I can't wait to see where Halo Infinite takes us. Anyway fam, thanks so much for watching, please like the video if you enjoyed, and subscribe if you want to support me that little bit extra. Thanks guys, have a good one.